Hello everyone, and welcome back to Mod of Minecraft with Nightdagger, episode 5 of my Let's Play series, season 3. Just coming back in, did a little bit of work off camera, not a whole lot. I came in here and I got my warehouse straightened out. I am a little bit concerned by the fact that this spot looks dark, but Monster Spawn Highlighter assures me it's not, and there's a torch there and a torch there, so there's no reason it should be a problem. Got everything sorted out here. I did go and collect a whole bunch more soul sand, and I got some more nether brick. That's going to be important for us soon. You can see I also got some rubber. That's because there's something that I want to get started on this episode that the discovery last episode has lent itself to. I'm just about to break my pickaxe, and I don't want to go through any more diamonds just digging up random dirt or crap like that. So I'm going to come over here, and I'm going to kidnap one of my iron furnaces. Thank you. Actually, I'm going to kidnap them both. No reason to have them out here anymore, right? And we're going to do a little bit of work with these. We are going to come down here. And we're going to grab ourselves a handful of copper. Got some bronze there, too. We're also going to need a bit of tin. We're going to need some iron to start cooking up into some refined iron for us. So let's go ahead and get a whole stack of iron cooking up into refined. We're going to need it sooner or later. May as well make it sooner. And let's go ahead and make ourselves some copper wire. And let's go ahead and insulate that copper wire. We're also going to need a bit of redstone. May as well grab that now. And with the first 3 refined iron we get, there's a symbol I hadn't seen yet this episode, or this season. Wonder what that is. We'll have to check it out at some point. We're going to do a little bit of this, and that's going to give us a battery. And we're going to take our iron furnace, we're going to put 3 refined iron over it, and the battery up there, that's going to give us our first generator. We're going to make 3 more batteries. And combine with a little bit of wood. Actually, you know what? No, we're not going to do that. We're going to hold on to those batteries. I have a bunch of rubies here, and I have enough gold. I don't have any resin, though. Yeah, we'll want it eventually. We're going to go ahead and make ourselves a bath box. No reason not to have it. Even if we are going to eventually just pop to an MFE, and possibly even the whole way up to an MFSU early in this series, there's no reason not to have a bat box. We'll need it eventually. We're going to make ourselves an electronic circuit. We're going to make ourselves a machine block, and we're going to grab a handful of wood here. We're going to go ahead and make ourselves an extractor. Because right now, resin is easily one of the most difficult resources for us to acquire. We still have some copper wire. That's good. We're going to bring our generator, our bat box, and our extractor up here. This is my build craft room. Or, not my build craft room. This is my industrial craft room. So, we're going to dig ourselves a hole in the floor right here. And let's see, how do I want to do this exactly? I think what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to want to have the bat box. I'm going to pop down here for just a second. Oh, that's not what I meant to do. I think I want to have the bat box on that level, but facing down. Like that. Let's head back upstairs. And, ooh, I got a new resin, new tree for the resin spot. Where'd my resin go? What? Weird. Oh no. Don't care. I got a few more trees. Need to come out here and clean these up. Let's go ahead and tap him. Of course, I would throw the resin spot over here. Where'd my resin go? Cough it up. I got a few more rubber tree saplings, but my resin seems to have vanished again. Nope, there it is. It just fell down. Alright. We got another spot there. Another spot there. We got one here. I decided I wanted to go for kind of an unusual, more nature-y feeling rubber tree farm, as opposed to having the nice, neat lineup of trees. Just because otherwise everything feels a little too industrial. I'm trying to get away from that a little bit here. All right. Now that we got our bat box in position, let's come up here. We're going to need our copper cable, which we're going to feed underneath the flooring here. And that's going to be good for now. Because all we're running right now is an extractor. Then on the side here, we're going to put our generator, and we're going to feed it some coal. Just enough to get us started with some power in our bat box and our extractor, and we're going to go ahead and get our resin extracting. A little more coal. There we go. We'll head back downstairs. Actually, no, we'll not head back downstairs. I got to come back up here, grab a handful more resin to be able to do what I want to do. All right, we'll come down here, back in our metals chest, we'll grab that 9 steel that we got before. We're going to make ourselves another handful of copper wire. From that, we're going to make ourselves another battery, another copper cable, or electronic circuit, not copper cable. And from that, we're going to take that, and we're going to take our steel, and we're going to make ourselves a mining drill. Awesome. We're going to take him upstairs and charge him. Pop him in there. Now, we're not quite as reliant on pickaxes. Don't worry, I am eventually going to put something in place that's going to minimize all this walking around. Because walking is for chumps. Alright, as soon as this finishes up, actually, we'll hold off on that for now. Let's go ahead and make ourselves a little more of this insulated copper wire. Let's make ourselves another electronic circuit. Grab our tin, make ourselves another battery. And, oh, damn it. Alright, sorry about that. I've been having a weird problem recently where my Minecraft likes to minimize itself anytime I hit the R key if I don't have it properly on here. So, Let's go ahead and look up the recipe for the electric tree tap. And see, it's 3 pieces of steel, a battery on top, which is kind of weird. There we go. That gets us our electric tree tap. We don't have to worry about this thing anymore. Let's come upstairs. Sleep through the night. Had enough fun with creepers for one day, so rather not have any more. Any creepers? No? I don't see any. See a cow. See a bunch of cactus. Need to get some automation on that cactus farm soon, I think. Let's take our new trees and plant them down here somewhere. Say there and there. That's good. Alright, let's clean up our inventory. Grab a bite to eat. We'll keep the pickaxe on us. And we're going to put the metal away for the moment. We're going to be coming back here very soon. Dust, we'll put that away. And we'll put the cable and the rubber in our industrial craft chest. The wood we'll put in here. Cobblestone we'll put in here. The chicken we'll put in our mouth. Alright. Now, if we come out here, we can see that our combustion engine here has stopped running. Let's turn off any eye for the moment. Combustion engine has stopped running, and there's almost no power in either of these machines, which means it's perfect time to pick them up. These machines you can pick up using a pickaxe. A buildcraft wrench is faster. I just don't have it on me. Oh! I am having no luck with these things today. At least I spotted that one before he blew something up. Alright. Take that. Are there any more? I just looked for creepers, too. Saw nothing. Turn your back for a second. Oh, hi! That's a very nice combustion engine you have there. Alright. We're going to move this stuff indoors. And we're going to add to it. Now, an aqueous accumulator, if it's fully powered with a couple of source blocks of water on each side of it, supplies enough water to... I just lost my train of thought. Supplies enough water to theoretically cool 4 combustion engines. However, buildcraft pipes are a little derpy when it comes to transmitting water. I've found a better practical limit to be about 2, without any sort of risk. So I'm going to go ahead and get myself some waterproof pipe. I'm going to grab a bit of wood, a bit of iron. May as well just grab a whole bunch of it. Some cobblestone. And redstone. Can't forget the redstone. And we're going to make ourselves piston. We're going to make ourselves 2 gears. Cobblestone. To iron. And that's going to give us our combustion engine. We got two combustion engines, we got the pulverizer, we got the powered furnace. One combustion engine was more than enough to power those. What do we need that's gonna, what do we have that's gonna require that much power? We're gonna make ourselves a couple new items. The first one we're going to make is called the induction furnace, or the induction smelter. Not to be confused with the induction furnace from Industrial Craft. This is the induction smelter. It requires one of those machine frames, a couple pieces of sand, a bucket, some copper, and one of those redstone reception coils. So let's go ahead and get to crafting. We need a couple pieces of sand, and we need a bucket. I'm going to make a new bucket. I want to keep two buckets on hand here. Glass. Oh, no. Glass in the corners, gold in the middle, iron on the edges, gets us the machine frame. Gold in the middle, redstone on the sides, gets us our redstone reception coil. Iron in a V, gets us a bucket. If you don't know this one, go back to vanilla. Sand, I need copper. Couple pieces of copper, couple pieces of sand, machine frame, bucket, redstone reception coil gives us our induction smelter. We need two more items here. This is going to be a pretty major build. The first one we need is called the magma crucible. It's this guy right here. It's a couple pieces of nether brick. Told you we'd need it for a reason. Another bucket, another machine frame, and another redstone reception coil. So let's go ahead and come over here to our oddity bricks and grab two nether bricks. Make another bucket. Make another one of those machine frames. Make another redstone reception coil. Copper again. Copper, coil, frame, another brick. Bucket gives us our magma crucible, and then the last one we need is the liquid transposer, which is another bucket, another redstone reception coil, another machine frame, two more pieces of glass, and two more copper ingots. So once again, we'll do a little bit of that, combine with a little bit of that, put you there with you. Copper, glass. Need another bucket, don't I? Yep, another bucket. Bucket, machine frame, coil, copper, glass gets us our liquid transposer. We should have everything we need to begin this build, except we are going to want a crap ton of redstone. We're also going to need some lead. Just so happens I have some lead right here. Let's head up to our intended build craft room, or rather, this is going to be our thermal expansion room right here. No, that's not. Up here. This one that I created. Ooh, this is dark in here. Forgot to light up the inside. That should be good. Alright, we need a good place to have our engine sit. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to have the aqueous accumulator sit over here in the corner. And actually, do I want him there? I don't think I want him there. I think I want to countersink him. Yep, I'm going to countersink him into the side of the tower here. This last part isn't technically necessary. Actually, that's going to cut out into our room, isn't it? Yep, Not gonna do that. I'll do it over here. We're gonna put our... Well, we need to seal this off, don't we? There we go. Put our aqueous accumulator. As soon as we find it again. Gonna put that right there. We're gonna need to go get a couple of buckets of water. I should have grabbed my buckets in advance. Tools, buckets. Come upstairs. Make a quick stop by my Thaumcraft room to grab some water. And we'll put a source block there. Another one there. And it's not technically necessary, but I like having three source blocks around it. Just in case something were to happen to one of them, I've got a backup. Alright. Out of the top of that, we're going to have our golden waterproof pipe, which is going to come up right over here. And that's going to feed into our combustion engines. I need some more buildcraft pipe here. Like, I'm going to need a significant amount of golden pipe for what I'm about to do. So let's come over here and see if we have anything left over in our buildcraft chest. We have some wooden conductive. We've got a bit of golden conductive. That might be enough. I don't want to go overboard with the golden conductive. Head back upstairs. And on top of here, we're going to have... I don't like that. Yeah, I don't like that. I want my waterproof pipe to come back around here, so that I can have the combustion engines. How do I want to do this? Haven't previously thought this out in advance. The issue with not previously thinking things out in advance is that when it comes time to actually do it, I'm kind of at a loss. Follow the bouncing pipe. No. Do it just like that. And we'll have the conductive pipe come off the top. And we'll have that lead around the room this way. Don't want it that high. Well, it has to be that high to get started here, unless I run it off the front here. How do I want to do this? I don't really want to run it off the front. We'll just do it this way. Not that way. This way. Yes. No. Yeah, we'll just do it this way for now. There's better layouts, but this one will serve our purposes. And I need my buildcraft wrench. I don't think I've even made one this season. Or maybe I did. Maybe I tossed up my tools chest. Tools, do I have a buildcraft wrench? No, I don't. Easy enough to fix. A piece of wood. Makes a gear. This makes stone gear. This makes Billcraft wrench. And we're good to go. Now, if we take a look at these, you can see they've nicely filled up. Our aqueous accumulator is completely full. We're going to need a way to power this with redstone. I'm thinking just some redstone dust in front of it for now. But let's go ahead and get our equipment set up here. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to have the induction smelter. It's going to kind of sit in the corner here by itself. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to have the liquid transposer and the magma crucible, and they are going to be parked next to each other for a reason I'm about to explain. You can see we've got the magma crucible here, has a blue end and a red end. Well, this side over here is blue. We don't want it to be blue. We want it to be red, so we're going to change that in the configuration. You can see it now is. That side is too, but we don't care. The liquid transposer we're going to put there, and we're going to set that. The blue needs to be on this side. We're going to take the blue in there, and we don't really care about the other facings. We don't need them at the moment. We do need a bit more golden conductive in order to put our pulverizer and our powered furnace back down, but we'll deal with that later. So, actually we might not even need that at all from something I'm about to do here. What we do need is power. Power is gained through a couple of buckets of fuel, a couple of pieces of redstone, and our lever. Let's come over here, catch snooze. We'll get this running, and then while this is running, I'm going to go craft the next component that we need. Damn it, I just forgot the fuel. After I get this thing running on some fuel here, I'm going to describe the next component that we need and what it does, and we'll get to building that while our materials get ready. Because this requires a material that it's going to take a little while to get prepared. I didn't want to do it off camera because the crafting of this is, in itself, a little bit non-intuitive, if you don't know. So I want you guys to have seen what goes into making this. I'm going to put a couple pieces of redstone dust there. We're going to put a lever on the floor, which is going to connect to the redstone dust. And we're going to turn it on. And our combustion engines are not going to get powered. Because redstone sucks. We're going to do it this way. The second piece of redstone isn't technically necessary. I don't care. I like it that way. We're producing power. Our machines are charging up. We've got our induction smelter charging up here. We've got our magma crucible charging up here. You can see how much internal power this thing holds. You can also see this thing consumes a crap ton of power at maximum load. That's why we wanted two combustion engines. And our liquid transposer here doesn't consume much power. But, yeah. So, what do we need to do? We need to toss a stack of redstone in this magma crucible and get that thing cooking up. This is going to take quite a while in order to work. So while that's going, we're going to go grab another component that we need that I forgot that I left outside. And we're going to creeper patrol while we're at it. God knows they love me today. We need this. This is pulverized obsidian. It's made by... Ready for this? I'm about to blow your mind. Putting obsidian in a pulverizer. Wow. Right? I know. I could barely believe it when I first heard it too. We're going to throw the pulverized obsidian and the lead in the induction smelter. What is this going to do for us? Well, after a fairly long wait, it's going to get us... Come on. I wasn't kidding when I said a fairly long wait. It's going to get us some hardened glass. And this over here, you can see our magma crucible is transporting all of its liquid into the liquid transposer. What liquid is this in here? It is actually molten redstone. One piece of redstone gives you 50 millibuckets of molten redstone. So it takes 20 pieces of redstone to get one bucket of molten redstone. Meantime, let's come up here, let's grab this. What we are going to make is we're going to make energy storage. And energy storage is going to require a couple pieces of lead, some of our electrum that we've had cooked up before, a redstone conductance coil, not a redstone reception coil. This one's different. This one is made with electrum in the middle and redstone on the sides. And an energy storage frame, which is going to be four pieces of hardened glass, a diamond, and four electrum ingots. Well, that's why we've been cooking up the hardened glass. Let's come down here and start crafting this up. In our metals chest, we're going to grab our electrum. We need a diamond. And over here, we're going to put the diamond in the middle, the hardened glass in the corners like that, and the electrum like that. That's going to give us our energy storage frame. This is going to give us our redstone conductance coil. And if we take a look at this again, it's some lead, some electrum. And I don't have any lead on me. Let's go upstairs and get some of our spare lead. Alright, if we come in here, we'll grab the rest of our lead out of here. We're storing up a nice amount of power. This will store up to a full 4,800 Minecraft joules worth of power before it stops accepting power. Over here, we're up to 9 Minecraft joules per tick usage. Over here, we're fully loaded, but we're not actually using any. Let's pop down a crafting table over here. That way we don't have to go back down. And we do this, that's going to give us our energy storage empty. There's an extra step here required before this becomes anything usable, and it involves this liquid transposer. You can see here it's got the little bubble pointing towards this blue thing here. We can click this and we can change it so that it would be going out instead of in, but we want it to come in instead of out. If we put our energy storage there, well, nothing's going to happen yet. We don't have enough molten redstone stored up for this to happen yet. Let's throw some more in there. It actually takes 2 buckets of molten redstone for this to work. In other words, 2,000 millibuckets. So we're at 1,500 right now. We're almost there. We're getting there. How are we doing on our combustion engines? Looks like we're doing all right. Our induction smelter, we got a couple of extra pieces of hardened glass here. Hello, Boris. While this runs, we're going to put this hardened glass to some use. If we take hardened glass and we put electrum on the outsides, that's going to give us this energy conduit. Now, we can't do anything with the energy conduit yet, because just like the energy storage, it requires an extra step. It requires some of this molten redstone. We're just going to wait here. 3 more pieces. 2 more pieces. Come on. 1 more piece. It's almost done. And here you can see, as soon as we got that 2000, that disappeared, and we have a redstone energy cell. What does this thing do? This thing is an amazing, amazing tool. It acts exactly like an MFE or an MFSU does for industrial craft power, except this stores build craft power. We now have a way to store build craft power and output it on demand. However, we can't do it straight from this. It'll take power in from conductive pipes, but it won't output it from conductive pipes. You gotta have something else. What do you gotta have? These. These are redstone energy conduits. If we break these off, from here, we can run our redstone energy conduits out of here. Shift, right click to immediately remove a redstone energy conduit that you've placed in the wrong place like an idiot. Just like that. Now you can see there is a little arrow on this thing pointing outward. And on this one, there's no little arrow. You can also see, if we look at this thing again, that we have quickly drained out all of our power. That's because what it's doing is it's taking in all of the power from these buildcraft engines, and it's now transmitting them into these devices over here. You can't really tell at the moment because this thing is burning up a lot more power than it's using. But eventually, once this gets down to about 12 Minecraft joules per tick, it'll stabilize because these are producing 12 Minecraft joules per tick worth of energy. So once we get down to 12, it'll keep running. We're going to burn up some more redstone in the magma crucible because we want to have a good amount of that stored. We want to have a lot of these energy conduits. The pulverizer and the powered furnace that we had earlier, let's go ahead and put them back down. Pulverizer there. Note the blue output. Powered furnace there. We've got the blue output going that way. We don't want it going that way. We want the blue output to be on the top. And we want the red on that side. And we want the yellow on that side. These will turn off. On this side, we want to be accepting from orange, outputting the blue. So, we're perfect just as is. I haven't really decided how I want to do this yet. For right now, I'll just do it this way. I'll have to feed the thing manually, but it'll work. You can see, we're pulling in energy. Still no energy stored in the redstone cell, but, and our power usage is going to drop some more here. Let's go ahead and take that out. Let this build a little bit of internal buffer back up, because now we're siphoning all of the power over into these furnaces. Light went out on the crucible. Pulverizer is just about fully recharged. Okay, pulverizer is fully recharged. Let's go ahead and throw this back in here. It's going to use 12.9, so you're going to see we're going to be losing a little bit of power. Not a whole lot. However, this gives us a way, once our magma crucible is done doing its work here, we don't have to worry about it. It's not going to blow up, it's not going to fry anything, we're not going to waste any power, because it's all going to get stored in here. As far as the use of this thing, we'll go into a little bit more depth with that once we get some charge in here. I'll explain all of this fancy stuff. But for right now, I think I've hit a good stopping point. This is Nightdagger with Let's Play a Mod of Minecraft. This has been episode 5. I might do one more episode today. I kind of want to touch on some Thaumcraft stuff, because I haven't done anything with Thaumcraft yet. I'm kind of itching to get going, so we'll see where that takes us. We'll see if I get anything else done today. Since I'm not going to be able to record tomorrow, I'll probably try, but we'll see. I'll catch you guys later.